you know, when Rich was talking and stuff like that, and listening to Pastor George Pearson this morning, you know, God really started dealing with me about us being more aggressive in our faith. Right now, you know, the reason that our church is in the state that it's in as far as, like, the numbers decreasing is because we haven't been aggressive enough in believing for people to come in. And it's really easy to look at the walls and the empty seats and let the devil tell us, you know, that's what our church is going to be. But we're going to have to get to the point, and that, you know, me and Rich, you know, as well as everybody else in agreement with us, that we are not going to let that, you know, let circumstances dictate who we are. Because there is an end time revival that's for this area. And guess what? We are going to be the church, and this is what God was speaking to me. If we'll take the challenge, if we'll do it and be the leading edge to bring in the revival in for this area. And if we're not aggressive about it, if we're not pursuing it, if we're not believing it, you know, we can pass away. And hopefully there's somebody ready that would be able to take the mantle and go with it. But more than likely there's not. You know, because most people don't believe in faith or believe the things that we believe as far as who we are in God and what He has for us. So, you know, this God has this plan for us. He really does. And it's going to be up to us to push through. And a lot of the circumstances that happen, it's because the enemy's coming against us. It's because he wants to stop it right now before it can take root, before it can start going. But in Jesus' name, greater is He that's on the inside of us than he that is in the world. And we will not stop. We'll not go back into Egypt. But we will press forward. But it's time for us to press. To press in the spirit. To press in the natural. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You know, like Carrie was saying, when we say the word, this is what about being a household of, about being in the household of faith is all about. Is when we say the word faith in our circles, it means totally something different to somebody else over at XYZ Church saying faith. Because most people don't believe and don't know what faith is. We were talking early this morning, and I said, you know, I don't even know if the word is feeling sorry, because I don't like to use the word sorry, but I really feel bad for the people who don't know about how to live by faith. And people, you see, you can take the word faith and make it negative or possible, or positive. And that's why it's so important that how you say something, in the context that you say it in, it can mean two totally different things. I was giving an example this morning that we can say, "Brother, how you doing today?" Well, I'm just trusting God. No faith. How you doing this morning, brother? I'm just believing God. I'm hoping it'll work out. That's not faith. And 99.9% of the church is talking that way. We just believe. We're just believing. Just believing what? But now watch this. You take that same phrase. How you doing today, brother? Bless God. I am trusting God. Hallelujah. He's meeting all my needs according to and based upon His riches and glory through Christ Jesus. Man, you better believe I'm trusting God. Hallelujah. How you doing today, brother? Man, I am standing on the word. I am standing in faith. Praise God. See the difference? You make it what it is. You make it what it is. It can be negative or it can be positive. And man, when I say I'm standing on the word, that's what I'm doing. I'm standing on the word. And we taught on being aggressive this morning. Was teaching, Pastor Jordan Glory was teaching on being aggressive, just like a bulldog, having bulldog faith, glory to God. And latching down on something and not letting it go. And that means standing firm. I said, you know, if you think that the enemy is just going to let us waltz in this place, waltz in this city, and just let us come in and all of God's glory, man, we no, what's going to happen? He's going to do everything, put every trial, put every test, put every temptation in our way. We're coming up on 9 years. Coming up on 9 years in July. And in those 9 years, now the first year, he let us kind of, you know, the enemy just let us, you know, slide by. I mean, everything was, when I tell you we had favor when we first came in this city, I mean, favor upon favor was upon us. We could just believe or ask for something and bam, it would happen. You know? And so the enemy was giving us, the enemy was kind of giving us a vacation. You know? And that things were happening for us. A man, you know what? He was checking to see, all right, how on fire are they? Let me analyze. You know what he was doing? He was analyzing us. Checking us out. Are we for real or not? Is these guys for real? And for 9 years, that's what's been going on. There's been a battle, in case you don't know it, going on. And who's he going to hit first? Well, he's going to hit the leadership. He's going to hit the top first. He's going to hit the pastors. He's going to hit the leadership of the church. That's who he's going to go after first. That's who he's going to begin tempting to get him. You know, if you don't think in 9 years we haven't been tempted to quit and give up, 9 years we've been believing God. Man, for this thing to take off, for this thing to grow. And what? You're not the one that has to give an account for everything. When I stand before God, I'm the one that has to give an account for the mission and the vision that He gave us for this city. And this vision, when God gives you a vision and God gives you a mission, it's not about how many people come or how many people get involved. It's, are you going to stand and do it? And we've heard several ministers before, and you know, Pastor Allen, Terry, and if it just meant Karen and I came in here and there was not a soul sitting in these seats, God sent us here for a mission. God sent us here with a vision, praise God. And so it's up to us to see that vision come to pass. Now, God will send people our way. That's why He sent you here, amen? He sent you here, and I don't want to get over in our vision in March. Don't forget, we'll be going into to March members, praise God. And we're going to teach on the vision of this church. We're going to teach on what God's called us to do and how you have a part in it. And so I believe now whenever God calls you to this church, He does give you a responsibility, praise God. And He didn't call you just to come in here and be a bench warmer and just sit on the church. I mean, sit on the pew and or sit on the chairs as we got in here. He didn't call you just to come here and sit down and fold your arms and go, okay, preach to me, Pastor. Make me feel happy. You know, let me go back home after an hour, hour and a half, whatever, or 45 minutes, however long you preach. Make me happy so I can hurt them and go home. He didn't call you to come here and do that. Word of Life is not a sit ye church, we're a go ye church. Praise God. Not a sit ye, so we're not going to sit. And so as spring gets here, amen, we're going to spring out. And we're going to take it to the streets, amen? And it's time for us to quit, and this comes back on us. It's time for us to quit talking the talk and start walking the walk. Amen? We can talk all day long. Amen? We can talk about doing something all day long, but until we put action with it, we're not going to get no results. Praise God. That's the same way with faith today. Faith has to have action with it. You just can't say, well, I believe. No, there has to be some action with that. Praise God. Well, I believe God meets all my needs. Well, where's your action with God meets all my needs? Praise God. I know I've been in all kinds of churches. Man, you can mention stuff on tithing. You can mention stuff on giving. And you can say, bless God. You know, God's called us to be tithers. And, you know, the whole church is shout hallelujah. You know, how many of them really believe in tithing, though? How many is really giving? How many's really given their gifts? How many's really given their tithe? Amen? And people amen you all day long, but their actions show something different. Amen? We talked this morning about bulldog faith and how we see, and I've mentioned this before, but we see the Copelands, we see the Duplantises, we see the Savelles and Brother Keith and Phyllis Moore, and we see all these great men and women of God, and we immediately, oh man, I want what they want. Well, you got to go back and listen how they got there. You don't wake up the next morning and all of a sudden, you know, you're rich. You don't have nothing. You don't have. I wake up every morning, but I'm rich. Praise God, that's my name. So, but you don't wake up every morning. Voila, it's there. That's not how it operates. It takes action with your words today. Faith without what works is what? It's dead. Amen? So it requires action on your part. When it comes to believing God for your healing, it requires action on your part. That means getting in the Word of God. And like the Lord was saying this morning, praise God, getting in the Word of God, applying those healing scriptures, you don't take no, like we sung this morning, as Barry Tubbs is the one that coined that phrase, the first report is not the last report. Glory to God. The first report you get from the doctor, that ain't the last report. Amen. I choose to believe the report of the Lord, what He says about me. Amen. I'm battling things in my body right now that I'm going through, but I've got to stand on the Word of God. There's some things in my body that a concern can be there, but I've got to stand on the Word of God. And I'm looking in the mirror preaching to myself. I got to believe what God's word is. That means I don't go to doctors. I don't use doctors. No, that ain't what we're talking about. Amen? It's okay to use a doctor. Amen? It's okay. That's what God created them for. And God gave them. You know that God gave them the knowledge? But knock that microphone stand over. God gave us doctors. God gave us nurses. Praise God. But they're not the final authority. We go to them, but now that's where you're. If you can't believe you're healing, then you better go. If you're facing the doctor, that's where you better go. If it's not in the Word, I got trouble. I got trouble thinking you're going to survive if your faith's not in the Word, because that's what's going to keep you alive is this Word right here. The doctor's not going to keep you alive. The Word is going to keep you alive. The Word. Your job is not going to meet your need. God is going to meet your need. Right. Who is your nurse this morning? Make a quality decision. And a quality decision means I believe it with everything within me. Nothing else matters, praise God. I'm going to stand on this Word right here. I'm going to be aggressive about this Word. And so when I'm needing healing in my body, this is the report I right here. This is the report that I'm going to believe. This is the report I'm going to stand on. So things don't happen on that when the Copelands were in that old broken down car and they're in that project house they were talking about. That's where they started out. And just by overnight, it didn't just happen for them. Amen? Jesse preaching in churches and they hand him a Dr. Pepper. This is your offering. This is your love offering. We're giving you a Pepper to drink. Jesse still has that in his office. So he can look at where he came from. Sleeping in a cold. Y'all remember those old churches? I know I went to one. They had the churches on top and all the Sunday school rooms is in the bottom. Half time the church is so cold. It's, you know, it ain't funny because there's not real good heat and stuff going in down there. And when we went to go preach at this church, Jesse went to go preach at this church when he was a young minister. Went to go preach at this church. They put him down. Hotel room, nothing. Put him down in one of them old cold Sunday school rooms with a little pallet to lay on. Not a bed, nothing. Gave him a little pallet to lay on with some blankets and stuff. And walked in and handed him a Dr. Pepper. And that's how he started. It was just like that. But you know what? Of course he was tempted to give up and quit through those years. And man, we've listened to Jerry Savelle on God is my source. you to get that series, if you can get your hands on it. It's called God Is My Source by Jerry Savelle. And man, Jerry goes through all the things, and God met him and Carolyn's needs, praise God, when they didn't have nothing, hallelujah. And look where they are today. God wants to do the same. He has no respecter of persons, but you got to start somewhere, amen? Faith without actions is dead. And so what did the Copelands do? They made a quality decision. Only going to do what we see the Father do. We're only going to say what we hear the Father say. And I'm already getting ahead of myself, but that's okay. We're not going to try to keep you long here today, praise God. That's become a joke now, hasn't it? But you have to put actions with your words, amen? And so when we're saying that we're believing God for something, Carrie and I, every time we get in there, guess what we're doing? We're believing God for a brand new car, debt-free car. And so I believe somebody out there watching this video is going to get, no, I'm kidding. I believe in Jesus' name, God's going to give us a debt-free car, amen? A new car, not one about to fall down. Somebody says, I want to give it to you. That ain't how you sow. You saw people that some people sow things and it's falling apart, then they want to give it away. That's not good seed. You give somebody your best, praise God. And so, three brand new shirts, amen, that I ordered from China, and I just got to find somebody skinny enough that can wear them. And they were supposed to be. I ordered these things now, and they had an American size. So I went by the American size chart, they say that it is, and so I said, well, just to be on the safe side, I'm going to order these things in 2X. So I ordered 2X, one of them I ordered 3X, and got these things in the mail, and I knew when it came in the package, I was in trouble. And so these things are, you know, made in China, direct from China. It took almost a month to get to me. And they were cool shirts. Some of them I got for the band. I was going to wear in the band stuff, you know. And then I bought a couple of nice dress shirts for Sunday morning. And opened them packages up. I don't even think Caleb and them can fit into them. If it tells you anything. And that's there. I said, my gosh, how skinny are they in China? You know, when I think of China, I'm thinking Buddha, you know, Buddha Billy. Big old thing sticking out. And I'm not... So I'm kind of like, I'm kind of like, you know, how people in China, man. Goodness gracious, I got a 2X and a 3X and my own kids can't even fit in them, man. Much less me, I was trying to put one in my arm and it got stuck right here, me trying to put the arm on. So if that tells you anything, so it's awful. I said, so now I'm looking for a very skinny person I can sew the brand new, so I can sew them shirts into them, man. Praise God, I'm going to give them to them. Hallelujah. So... Of course, they not like what they look like, but, you know, because they're rock and roll, you know, so they may not like that. Got to be aggressive in your faith. Let me get on track here. We have got to be aggressive in your faith. 1 John 5:4 says this, for whosoever is born of God overcometh the world. No, notice what he said right there. For whosoever is born of God overcometh the world. This is God putting his faith right there. Whoever's born of me, praise God, overcomes the world. Now that is your choice if you want to overcome or not. Because we're not born again Christians, spirit filled Christians, who are not overcoming the world. They're caught up. You know, we're talking about religion this morning. You know? People growing up in religion, they have this religious idea of things. I'm so glad we found out about the grace of God, man. Because a lot of religion is caught up in the law instead of grace. Praise God. Now. I grew up in a church. I grew up in a church, a denominational church, and though they believed in grace, they still believed in the law at the same time. And so they put this, you know, what you could wear, what you couldn't wear, how long your hair ought to be, you know, and men couldn't have beards, and They can have a mustache, but I've never figured this out. It was okay to have a mustache. This is what law is. This is what religion is. It was okay to have a mustache, but you couldn't have a beard. Your hair can come down to your collar, but can't go over your collar. That's called religion. Women weren't allowed to wear pants. Religion. Wore pants outside the church, you know. If it wasn't good enough to wear in church, it ain't good enough to wear outside church. You know, if you're going to come. If we get caught up in crazy. I could go on and on and on about religious stuff, man. It goes on in the church. And if we're not careful, even in the word of faith movement, we can become religious about some things if we're not careful about it. Amen? Brother Hagin said he couldn't even, you know, the word police was out. And so it was like correcting you on everything. They correct you on everything you'd say wrong. You know, oh, and we've been around them, man. Oh, you can't say that. Oh, don't say that. Oh, you can't say that. Oh, well, some of that's over the top. Now, you've got to say stuff that lines up when you're believing and standing. In fact, you've got to believe stuff that is founded, and you stand on the Word of God. Brother Hagin got up and made a joke one morning, during a Sunday service, and all he was doing was telling a joke, and the word police come up to him and said, "Dr. Hagin, what you said wasn't scriptural. You can't be saying that." And he said, "It was a joke, man. You know, get over this religious stuff." That's Dr. Hagin, you know, the one that taught us about talking right and saying right. Amen? He said, some people just can't quit being religious on it. Base it on the Word of God. Praise God. When you're believing faith, when you're standing in faith, it's got to be based on the Word of God. You've got to be aggressive in your faith. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith, praise God. There's a place of release where anyone who doesn't compromise the Word of God. I said this last week. This bears witness, and this bears saying again. I said this last week. Choose. Now listen to me. Choose to alter your lifestyle to fit His Word, not the other way around. Choose to alter your lifestyle to fit His Word, not the other way around. Well, how do we alter that? Well, God, here comes the bill collectors. What are we doing? We're not altering our life. Well, the phone's ringing at the bill collector. Man, we owe so many bills. Man, we're behind on our house payment. We're behind on our rent. We stay in that mindset. What have we done? We've altered our lifestyle around the circumstance instead of altering our lifestyle around God's Word. We've twisted it. And what we're doing is God, you're a liar. Whenever I became a tither, well, I don't see nothing happening. And then we quit tithing, and what we do, we've called God a liar is what we've done. We've given up and we've quit. Well, God, I don't see, I've been standing on your word for my healing. I don't see nothing. What have we done? We've called God a liar. And what have we done? We've decided to believe what a man or woman have said, or what a society has said, or what the news has said, or what the government has said. We've chosen to alter our lifestyle around that instead of what God's Word says. And we got to come to the place in our life, hallelujah, where we make a quality decision. That word, and I heard Brother Copeland preach on that, man, it just really began to strike something in me. A quality decision. And a lot of people use that word and just throw it out there for a cliche saying. But you have to make a quality decision that you're going to live by faith, stand on faith. What does a quality decision mean? Come hell or high water, I don't care how much the storms come, care how much the trials come. I'm going to stand on His Word. Believe what His Word says. That's my quality decision. Praise God. I'm going to stand on the Word of God no matter what. Why? What will happen? Because I'm born of God. Oh, you got to say that. Get up and say that in the morning. Because I'm born of God, hallelujah, I have overcome this world. What's overcome this world? Even my faith, praise God. That's exciting news. My faith in what? My faith, not just my natural faith, but my faith in, see, we have natural faith. When you come in the morning, we don't think. Now, let me show you. This is how faith in God's Word ought to offer. Give you an example here. When I take this chair right here, and every one of us do this, when you walk in of a morning to church, how many come in here and go, let me see if this thing, I don't know. I don't know if it's going to hold me up or not. I don't know if I want to sit here or not. We don't do that. What happens? We walk straight in these doors. Got a smile face. How you doing today? I'm blessed. Hallelujah. How you doing? I'm blessed. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. What we do? We don't think a thing in the world about sitting down in that chair. Why? We got faith that that chair, when we sit down, is going to hold us up. I used to use this example, but I still do, but it can be a bad example sometimes. We come to a four-way stop. And that car on the other side, you've got faith that car is going to stay in there, they're going to stop. But I found out over the years, you know, that don't always happen. A lot of people run that stop sign, man. You got to be careful what you do. But the chair is a great example. We don't think nothing about it. We go into strange places sometimes. We go to sit down. We go into restaurants, and we don't think twice about sitting down in that chair. Why? Faith is that chair is going to hold me up. That chair is going to do what it was created to do. And that's where we got to become in our spiritual life. Is that no matter what, bless God, well, the doctor's got this. Well, hallelujah, praise God, I'm healed in Jesus' name. I stand on His Word today. Glory to God. And you can't get over into what was Keith Moore bringing out the other day? About there's a difference between just saying something and saying it just to say it without faith. A lot of people just say something to be religious. Like we said, I believe God wants to. God will heal you today, and oh yeah, I believe it. But you really don't. And you meet people all the time. What happens? Their lifestyle. When it comes to healing, when it comes to prosperity, when it comes to relationships, and what their lifestyle will let you know what they really believe. As I said, it takes 5 minutes to stand with somebody and talk to them and let you know where their faith is. I can tell you all day long they believe, but their fruit, that's the word I was looking for, their fruit's going to show what they really believe. Their mouth's going to say what they really believe. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. I can tell you all day long when I'm in front of you guys, oh, I'm healed. Praise God. I believe I'm healed. Glory to God. Oh, I believe God meets every need I have. I'll start quoting you the scripture. When I get outside these doors right here, what's my fruit? What is my fruit? Now, this ain't a message of condemnation. Praise God. Don't take it that way. All right? We're not here to condemn anybody. We're here to help you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Encourage you to build you up. To get rid of that what? Stinking thinking. I've got this stinking thinking going on. And I want to change that. We're trying to help you change that. But this is we're about to read the scripture right here. Go to Romans. Romans 10:8 says this. Amen. The Word is near you. The Word is near you. It's not. Let's go there. Because I want you to see it. And they can bring up those Romans. What I say was Romans 10:8. Romans 10:8. Hallelujah. Romans 10. But what saith it? The Word. Whose Word? God's Word. The Word is near you, even in your mouth. Praise God. This is. And this is what he was preaching here. Paul was preaching right here. What saith it? The word is near you, even in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. We didn't come this morning just to preach junk to you. We didn't come to bring you a happy, feel-good message. Although that's good to feel happy, it's good to feel good. Amen? But our purpose is to come in here and make you feel happy so you'll hopefully not give you any substance. Amen? We want you to have substance. And there's substance in God's Word this morning. But what saith it? The word is near you, even in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we preach. Praise God. Here's the process. We'll get ready to close here. Everybody goes, yay. Here's the process. Faith comes when you hear the word. That's why it's so important to have Believer's Voice of Victory Network on, to have, and I love that. You know, I've never thought about this until we're bringing it out today. And but the Believer's Voice of Victory Network is the first network to have the Word of Faith only on it. And there's other Christian channels out there. But man, and other Christian networks, but some of the junk you hear is just awful. And you have somebody preaching Word of Faith one minute, and there's somebody dissecting it and trying to pull it all apart in another sermon comes on after him. And I'll never forget whenever we used to be on the radio station. What was it? Word of Faith Radio? Not on that station, because he only allowed Word of Faith preaching on there. And on a local station here, and I'll never forget. I mean, you would preach. Here I was preaching faith, standing on God's Word, and somebody come behind and try to tear me down, tear the message down that I was preaching. Junk like that, confusing people. You know? Well, God's not the author of confusion. The devil is. And so when you start getting confused over, well, I wonder, is it right that I should stand for my healing? That I should stand and believe for my finances? Is it right that I should stand and believe for my relationships? Based on the Word of God, yes, it's right. Hallelujah. Don't let somebody come behind you and try to tear that down, and you'll hear junk on the radio. You'll hear junk. Thank God for Believer's Voice of Victory Network, where all you hear is faith. And ain't nobody gonna come on that network unless they preach faith. Hallelujah. And so I like what they said. Amen. It's trusted word that you can believe. Praise God, because it's coming straight from the Word of God. It's coming straight from the throne room of God. Hallelujah. Faith comes when you hear the word. You believe and you say it. And then the Spirit of God does. Go to Romans 10 while we're in Romans. Romans 10:17. It's just right over from what we just read. So then, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. And when you translate that, it means faith comes by hearing and hearing and hearing and hearing. Not just, okay, bless God, I heard that message. I'm like Pastor Allen. I'm a repetitive preacher. And what am I trying to do? When I repeat a lot of things, it's to get it in your spirit. Praise God. Because it might have went like this right here the first time. Just like whenever God had me go back and preach the Believer's Authority, and I preached that first time about 12 weeks, and then God told me to go back and preach it again. Because why? We weren't getting it, amen? And I'll probably be going back again and preaching again, because a lot of people still didn't get it after preaching it the second time. And the Believer's Authority, the message on faith, is so vital for the times that we live in today. is we've got to know what our authority is in Christ Jesus today. Hallelujah. We've got to know what it means to stand and live by faith today. Faith comes when you hear the Word. You believe it, you say it. Then the Spirit of God does the work. So faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. God takes what you hear, God takes what you've been putting in your spirit, and then He begins to act on through His Word. Praise God. Hallelujah. So the more Word, the more result you're going to get. And we don't just listen to the Word of God. That's why I like watching the Word of God. I like listening to CDs. I don't know, there's something about when I go home and I watch it on television, or I watch a DVD of it. I like to watch and hear it, praise God. And so why? I get that in my spirit, man. Carrying our conscience. We're so real. It's time that, like Brother Copeland, when they made that quality decision, he said, God told them to get off, cut the TV off, cut the radio off, throw all the magazines away, throw the newspaper away, and only take this Word of God right here, dive into it, begin listening to they got all the Brother Hagin tapes and what's. That's why when you're hungry for God, amen? Why can't I go off the place to hear the Word of God preached, man? We're hungry. And I forever wanted him. That's how we take off to Lanes. That's how we're taking off to Jasper, Alabama. That's when we know there's a good Word of Faith meeting going somewhere close by. Amen. We want to be involved in it. We want to be in it. Why? So we keep that Word forever going in us. We've made a quality decision that we are going to live by this book right here and nothing else. We're not going to live by what the news says. We're not going to live by, see, you can't believe, the news had everybody believing Donald Trump wasn't going to be president. And if you listen to what they said, the news, and they still hadn't learned their lesson yet. And that certain party still hasn't learned their lesson. That's why they keep doing these hate things. And all these protests you're seeing. All they're doing is getting ready for 4 more years of it after the first. Because they're going to get it again. People are sick and tired of the nonsense. People are sick and tired of the mess. And I don't care who don't like that. Amen. Melinda Payne said. Sang a song last night called, what was it? I Don't Care What You Think. She sang a song she wrote about all that mess going on. I wrote a song about called I Don't Care What You Think. Amen. I'm going to stand on the Word of God and I'm going to proclaim the Word of God. Amen. And I don't care who gets mad at it and who doesn't get it. I don't care. I like Matt Hammond's message a few years back. It was called I Don't Give a Rip. I like that one, praise God. So Mac Havin said, I don't really give a rip what you think. I am going to stand on God, hallelujah. I'm going to proclaim His Word. I'm going to stand in faith, believing that what I've been standing, I'm going to keep on standing, I'm going to keep on standing, I'm going to keep on standing. Now as I'm standing, now that don't mean when he says keep on standing, that don't mean to go, oh, I'm standing. I'm just a standing. So I can go to another negative again. I'm just a standing here. Yeah, just a standing. Ain't nothing happening, but I'm going to stand. No, that's not what it is. When it means stand, it means you keep on standing on God's Word. In His Word, begin His Word. In His presence. Worshiping Him. Praise God. Forever keeping His Word before and pray. A couple said like this, glory to God. Hallelujah. When you're standing, pray in tongues, glory to God. Thing we're going to get in how for too long. We're going to talk about the importance of praying in the Holy Ghost, the importance of praying in tongues. And this time and this day that we're living in, we're going to have to pray in the Holy Ghost, man. And we're not going to get in that because I'll start taking off on another rabbit trail. Amen. Did you get anything out of that today?